Hi, in this tutorial I'll show you how to make a simple inverter which is commonly known as a cold cathode fluorescent lamp inverter. By this you can easily power any fluorescent lamp from a 12 volt power source, and it's common in most portable fluorescent lamps. At the input you have your 12 volts, the components are just a few. The inductor L1 isolates the high frequency from interfering with the power source. Capacitor C2 stabilizes the input voltage. For the transistors, you need two bipolar power transistors. You can use the TA2122. The base resistors R1 and R2 are 1.5 kΩ, but any from 680 to 2.2 kΩ will work well. The transformer is made up of a ferrite core or iron pounder, and the windings are 8 turns for each half of the primary winding, 3 for the auxiliary feedback winding, and about 30 turns for the secondary. These two dots indicate the winding sequence. The input goes to the center tap, and there's a capacitor C1 in parallel with the entire primary winding. The capacitor C1 in conjunction with the entire primary winding make an LC tank, and it will oscillate at its resonant frequency given by 1 over 2 pi root LC. The principle behind its working is very simple. When the circuit is first powered on, either of these two transistors will turn on first due to certain differences in their makeup as well as the circuit. SAQ1 conducts fast. It will allow current to flow from the power source through the inductor, through the primary winding, S3, S2, through the transistor and to ground. Current will continue to increase in this winding, and this will induce a magnetic field within the core. It will cause voltage to be induced in the auxiliary winding in a manner such that it will provide a positive bias at the base of Q1 and a negative potential at the base of Q2, preventing Q2 from conducting. After some time, the core is saturated, and since current cannot increase any further, it will cause the induced voltage to start collapsing, and so the polarities of the auxiliary winding will reverse in a manner such that you have a negative potential here and a positive potential at the base of Q2. This will cause Q1 to turn off very fast and Q2 to begin conducting. This will allow current to flow the other way around from the power source through the inductor and through the winding S3, S4, through the transistor Q2 and to ground. It will cause current to continue ramping up the winding S3, S4, and after some time, the core will saturate again and the magnetic field will begin collapsing. This will cause the voltage induced on the auxiliary winding to reverse in a manner such that it will cause Q1 to turn on again, and so the process will repeat many times per second. The frequency is determined by the inductance of the primary winding and the choice of transistors that you use. The voltage across the entire primary winding is pi times the inputs. With 12 volts, you will have an RMS voltage of about 27 volts at the inputs, and so the transformation ratio should be about 8 source to get 220 volts. With 16 turns on the primary side, you need about 100 turns on the output to get 220 volts AC. The output is a pure sine wave because the capacitor and inductor resonant circuit generates a pure sine wave across its terminals. And with this, you can power any load, such as a fluorescent lamp, or even devices that operate on switch mode power supplies. Thank you for watching, and I hope you liked this video. If so, make sure to give it a like, share with your friends, subscribe, and click the bell icon. And I'll see you in the next video. Have a nice time.